By Thursday, April 27th, Dublin was under heavy fire from British artillery. Of all the positions originally taken by Republican forces, only four were still holding out, and these were under constant and heavy siege. James Connolly, who had been directing military operations, was severely wounded. On Friday, April 28th, the post office was in flames and had to be evacuated. And at 3:45 p.m., Saturday, April 29th, Commandant-in-Chief Pearse issued an order to his troops.
In order to prevent the further slaughter of Dublin citizens, and in the hope of saving the lives of our followers now surrounded and hopelessly outnumbered, the members of the Provisional Government present at headquarters have agreed to an unconditional surrender, and the commandants of the various districts in the city and country will order their commands to lay down arms. P.H. Pearse, 29th April, 1916.
'Twas down the glen one Easter morn, to a city fair rode I, when Ireland's lines of marching men in squadrons passed me by.
No pipe did hum and no battle drum did sound its dread tattoo, but the Angelus bell or the Liffey swell rang out in the foggy dew.
In the 3 weeks that followed, 15 of the surrendered leaders were put to death before a British firing squad in the yard of Kilmainham Jail.
Oh, but we talked at large before the 16 men were shot. But who can talk of give and take? What should be and what not, while those dead men are loitering there to stir the boiling pot? You say we should still the land till Germany's overcome. But who is there to argue that? Now Pearse is deaf and dumb. And is there logic to outweigh MacDonough's bony thumb?
Right proudly high over Dublin town, they hung out a flag of war. It was better to die 'neath an Irish sky than at Suvla'r Sudelbar.
And from the plains of Royal Meath, strong men came hurrying through, while Britannia's sons with their long-range guns sailed in from the foggy dew.
It was England bade our wild geese go, that small nations might be free. Their lonely graves are by Suvla's waves on the fringe of the grey North Sea.
But have they died by Pearse's side, or fought with Valera true? Their graves we keep where our Fenians sleep 'neath the hills of the foggy dew.
How could you dream they'd listened, that have an ear alone for those new comrades they have found, Lord Edward and Wolf Tone, or meddle with our give and take, that converse bone to bone?
The bravest fell and the sullen bell rang mournfully and clear. For those who died at Easter tide in the springing of the year.
And the world did gaze in deep
amazed at those fearless men and true, who bore the fight that freedom's light might shine through the foggy dew.